In today's video, ZTE after a couple of days of usage. Fingerprint sensor. Very fast. Let's do it again. I love it. The screen itself is 120 Hz. Very smooth experience. Super smooth. And definitely feels very nice in the hand. It's not too wide, but slippery. You definitely need the case for it. Definitely. Benchmark scores are overwhelming. Only 808 to 2482. Built-in memory, 843 for 235 rewrite. It's also not insanely big, but it's okay, I guess. It's okay. I think it's plenty enough for any activities. By the way, let's try some gaming. Game. Let's consume some gaming with that beautiful screen. Graphics looks amazing. No glitches at all. And this is why it's fantastic for viewing. Look, in HDR, full screen, you don't see the camera at all. This is a compatible device with HDR. Okay, let me just look at it. Built-in speakers. This is the ZTE EX. Plenty of settings for the ZTE Axon, and it sounds really good. The sound is warm and you can listen for hours and hours without any issues, I guess. Now the camera. And bear in mind, in the camera department, you have three proper lenses. What does that mean? It means you can shoot full-size photos from all of them. 60 megapixels from wide angle, regular and telephoto. Also video in 8K from all the lenses. Camera family, multi-exposure, we have a macro, let me just bring for the macro, alright, macro, ooh, that's nasty, bam, wow, it's very nice. In the photo department, of course, front-facing camera, let me just... Okay, that's the front-facing camera. And like you can see, it looks like the front-facing camera is dirty, but it's not. This is the under-the-screen front-facing camera. And it's definitely just... It is what it is. You're not buying this smartphone for the front-facing camera. Yeah. Let's move on. Video, that's the same deal. Portrait, of course. Oof. It's all blurry and stuff. You'll be better off to shoot with one of those lenses. Okay, not exactly clean, my fingers. Now they're clean. All right, let me show you some samples. And bear in mind, there'll be a link in the description for you to check it out and download original samples without any compression. Cheesecake in wide angle with autofocus. Look at it. Wow, that's a new level of recording. I love it. That autofocus is extremely quick. Ooh. And the cheesecake smells beautiful. Picture wise and color accuracy in the red department, which is a red color, it's a bit oversaturated, but every other color looks okay. And bear in mind, 64 megapixels from every lens. Check this out. Wow. Try to do that with any other smartphone. There is no smartphone which could do that. This is the only one. 64 megapixels. Oh, sorry, 63 with telephoto. I love it. All right, let me just leave you with those pictures. I'll come back to you in a second. Battery, well, it is power hungry. This 5000 mAh battery will disappear in minutes. Okay, maybe not in minutes, but in very quick when you're using those beautiful cameras. This smartphone is definitely for the consuming, that seamless screen. There are seamless screen, but this one is really seamless. Because like Samsung's, the latest Samsung has that... You still see the pixels. This is smooth, no pixels at all. All you can see is plastic on the because I didn't take the plastic off. You see, camera's not visible at all. Conclusion: this smartphone has it all hardware-wise. Well, it's from last year, but fantastic built-in DAC. I'm talking about the audio experience and beautiful sounding and very loud built-in speakers. The DAC is so good that when I connect the Galaxy Buds from latest from the Samsung, it sounds better with this smartphone, ZTE, than the Galaxy smartphone itself. It will release the full potential English, on your headphones or earbuds. fantastic. The difference is insane, especially with the DTS and all those personal manual settings.